This video, I'm going to show you how to install Exalate on your Azure DevOps. On the left side of the screen, you can see the Exalate documentation. I'll use the docs as my primary reference. On the right, we have an Azure DevOps instance, and I will walk you through the installation step by step. So, let's begin. Head to the Azure DevOps Marketplace, Visual Studio, and look up the Exalate app. Just click on the link here, and it will take you to the marketplace. Now, click on the Get button to start the installation process. It will ask you to select the right Azure DevOps organization where we want to install Exalate. So select the right one. And that would be demo.org Exalate for me. As you see, this extension uses the read and write permissions. All right. Now go ahead and click Install. Once it's installed, you proceed to Organization. You can find Organization Settings at the bottom of the left sidebar. Then scroll down to the bottom of the sidebar and you'll see Exalate right under Extensions. The next step is to create a personal access token. Go to your user settings and you can find the personal access token under there. Now, click on the new token button. Give your personal token a name. You see the organization name and the expiration here as well. Note that we can keep the scopes as custom defined. All right. Now let's go back to the documentation because there is a separate doc on how to generate the personal access token for Azure DevOps. Click on this link and let's look at the required permissions. They're all mentioned here in the documentation. You just need to make sure that the user generating the PAT is from the project collection administrators, and that is a requirement. Now, in the PAT itself, you can give these particular scopes as read permissions. And for work items, we will need the read, write, and manage permissions. All right, let's go to the right sidebar and give the right permissions. If you don't see all the scopes, click on Show All Scopes here. For instance, for project and team, we need read permissions. For user profile, we need the same again. For identity, I need the read permissions as well. And then we click the same read for member entitlement. All right, time to create the token now. Once done, just copy the token, go back to your Exalate console and paste the token in the slot and save it. We now need to register and verify the instance. Exalate uses a token to verify the instance and activate the evaluation license. So, let's fill in the details and press Agree and Submit. Once done, you can expect an email from the Exalate License Manager. So, check your inbox. It might take a few seconds for it to arrive. And there it is. Now, click on Verify Exalate Instance and we'll be good to go when the email is successfully verified.